How can attackers execute a malicious file on a remote machine? How is it even possible? The answer is simple. You can do it by using the file inclusion vulnerability. The risk of it is mostly for Windows machine users that use new technology LAN manager or NTLM. In today's video, I will discuss how does file inclusion work. We will make a file inclusion attack based on Hack the Box Responder Challenge. The focus will be on testing passwords to match hash with John the Ripper. Before we start, subscribe on my channel so you don't miss the new videos. Let's first make us ready for practice and turn on the remote machines. I need to connect to PWN box and set a machine. Let's make a traditional nmap scan. Now, when I set the machine, I have a target IP. I will try to open it locally in the browser. The website redirects the browser to new URL, but this is unknown to host. The website is deploying a name-based virtual hosting. We see that when we put a certain IP in the domain name, there is no content. It means that the domain name does not match the IP address, and we can fix it by modifying etc host file. Now we can open the website. Let's find out more about it. I will use the Webalizer tool. I see that the website is made with PHP. Also, it uses Windows Server as an operating system and Apache as a web server. Checking the site, I see quite trivial content. However, there is one interesting parameter, the language. Based on the page parameter, the user can see the same content in English, French, or German. It means that the website is dynamic. What is so special about the dynamic websites? They have HTML pages that include another pages, and without proper validation of such inputs, the website can be attacked locally or remotely. This vulnerability is called file inclusion. With local file inclusion vulnerability, the attacker can see sensitive files that are not supposed to be seen by the other users. With remote file inclusion vulnerability, the hacker can load remote file on the host using different kinds of protocol like HTTP or FTP. Let's see the page parameter to check if we can include the files on the target. Let's try the most common example that is actually given us as a hint in Hack the Box. Great, so local file inclusion is possible with a case. Thank you. what is NTLM V2, or New Technology LAN Manager version 2? On Windows, the authentication is widely made with New Technology LAN Manager, or NTLM. It's a type of single sign-on for Windows old version. Despite being used for quite a while, it is still very popular. NTLM is structured as challenge and response mechanism. It supports one-side authentication. NTLM is good for avoiding unprotected passwords. However, the hashed variables are encrypted with insecure MD4 function and have no multi-factor authentication. Kerberos is a newer version to NTLM. With the responder tool, we can intervene in the NTLM process. When the target machine does authentication to the server, the responder sends a challenge back to the server to encrypt with the user passwords. So, when the server responds, responder will use the challenge and the encrypted response to generate NTLM version 2 hash. Because we cannot reverse the hash, we can try different common passwords to generate the same challenge response, and if we find one, we know that it is a password. Hash cracking will be done with John the Ripper. First, let's clone the responder repository to our local machine. Then let's make sure that the responder is on SMB server. For the case, the responder is already installed on PWN box, so it can be run by. I have an error with port 80. Open the responder conf and turn off the HTTP server. Now we can start. Here is the hash. The NTLM version 2 includes both the challenge and the encrypted response. We can copy the hash to a file. Let's create a file called hash. Now we need to pass the hash file to John and crack the password for the administrator account. The hash type is automatically identified by John command line tool. John will try each password from the given password list, encrypting the challenge with password. If the result matches the response, then it knows it found the correct password. The administrator account has been successfully cracked. The password is badminton. We will connect to Windows RM service on the target and try to get a session. Because PowerShell isn't installed on Linux by default, we will use a tool called Evil WinRM, which is made for that kind of scenario. We can try to find the flag under C users mic desktop flag.txt. So now you know how file inclusion attacks work. On Hack the Box there are more challenges. I hope that the file inclusion attacks are more clear to you now. If this video was useful, put a like to it, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and see you in the next videos. Bye!